We're here on Coachella Valley Music Show. We are at Pink Satellite Recording Studios. And we have with us this man who's Spike, who is the one who created this whole concept and idea of the studio here. He is the keyboardist for Queen of many years. Can you tell me why on earth you decided to do this studio?
Actually, the man who started it is Chris Haynes, who's the co-founder. He came up to visit me. I live just over there. And he came to visit me one day and said, "This place is fantastic. I need to get a place out here." And I went back to London, didn't think anything more of it. 6 months later, I return, and he has bought these premises and painted them pink.
And painted them pink. What did you think of the pink?
I can't tell you why. This is a family show, right?
Right. No, that's anything.
No, anyway.
It's internet.
At first, I was horrified because pink, this shade of Barbie, sting your eyes pink, is not really a desert color. And the folks in Joshua Tree kind of like things to be the traditional way. And after I sort of wiped water from my eyes looking at it, thinking, that's right next to my house. I warmed to it, and then he said, "Come over and see what I've done." And he showed me the space, which was the garage. I mean, the guy that used to live here, my mate Ray, I used to walk across here and drink beer while he made his own ammunition. That's what kind of house it was before.
What did it look like before this?
It was just a regular person's house. Trees everywhere, and a couple of old trailers, and a few cars with the wheels off.
Very regular desert. Joshua Tree.
Regular desert. Yeah. So, and I used to come over to this garage, as we call it, and sit with him while he made his own ammunition, and cats would roam around because you know that you need cats in the desert because of the rodents, right? The rodents will eat through the wiring in your car.
And then the coyotes will eat the rodents.
It's a food chain. Anyway, so I was used to the space, and all of a sudden it's pink, and I said, "So what is it now?" And he said, "Well, it's like a man cave," which is what it was. And he said, "I'm going to set up a few amps and a drum kit, and we're going to have fun." And I said, "I spend most of my life on the road, having fun.
Right.
I'm not sure that's what I want to do." And he said, "Or I could turn it into a studio." I said, "I'm going away for a few months. You do what you like." And when I came back, he said, "I've turned it into a studio." And I went, "Wow, he really has."
That's close, right?
Yep.
Okay, cool.
Interesting.
Okay.
You can do whatever. Okay, we're ready.
Thank you.
Don't lead me on if there's nowhere for you to take me. If loving you would have to be a sometime thing.
And two. And Scooby-Doo-Doo.
See before you is what was presented to me, and then my brain stopped rebelling, and I thought we could make this interesting.
Yeah,
and
that it is.
Yeah, and I said, well, if you want to go down this path, I'll go with you, and we'll push it as far as we can. But there has to be something. It's no longer a man cave thing where people come to mess about. Let's make it something where people actually come to enjoy the surroundings and be inspired. By the desert, which is
it well, is very the best view I've ever. I mean, of the desert. I mean, you can see all the way to the Jacinto Mountains and everywhere from here. It's
you can see two lots of snow-capped mountains when the sun is right. And as one of our first visitors said, when you look at that view, you feel that anything is possible.
Right.
And I like that line.
It's inspiring, and if you're feeling jaded and tired, it will. Inspire you, but it also relaxes you as well, because there's something about the desert that has that effect.
Right.
And all these things I found to be very positive. And I said to Chris, okay, we'll do this. I'm on board. Let's make it happen. As long as we can...
paint it any other color.
I talked about camouflage paint.
Yeah.
As long as we can take the studio and also help some young new artists, because it occurred to me that modern music is made by young people in their bedrooms on computers and in garages on computers.
Right.
And they don't get to have the experience that I had growing up in the 60s and 70s when all I did was go to proper studios.
Right.
So part of our modus operandi here, part of our thought is that we're going to encourage and help younger, newer musicians to have the recording experience.
Well, you know, you and I are on the same page on that, because I have the Coachella Valley Music Show, which is the same concept. It's to help the local musicians get seen, get heard, when they normally can't.
Yes.
It's a way to help them.
Yeah.
So you started doing that by going into the Teschner Fest and picking the winner of
what happened was, I was a judge at the Pappy and Harriet's Pioneer Town. There was a heat. There, one of the first heats for the Teschner competition, and the finale was going to be down in Coachella, which I wasn't invited for. So Victoria Williams, who lives up here and is a local iconic musician, and there were a whole bunch of bands on there, and one band came along and brought about 300 supporters, and when they came on stage, the place went crazy, and it was audience pressure for them to win.
Right.
But I didn't like them. I didn't like them, and there was nothing wrong with them. It just didn't move me.
You like the same band I do.
Well, the band that I chose, and
wonderful band.
We voted. The band that we chose that evening was a band called Brightner.
I really liked
the singer, and I really liked
wonderful
the fact
band.
That his sister was involved, and I heard something quirky and intriguing, and I thought there is something that can be developed here, rather than just the other bands. Actually, there were a couple of good bands on that night, but a lot of it was just copying stuff.
Same old thing.
Yeah. And you think, well, it's a competition, you want to look for something that has some future, if you think.
Right.
Anyway, not a popular choice. The audience hated me. I was glad. When we stood on the stage and announced the winners,
Not yet.
Could have dropped, could have heard a pin drop. It was like tumbleweed. No rounds of applause for the judges, no nothing, just a bunch of really upset fans in the audience from the other bands. And I thought, well, that's my judging career over.
That's all right.
Anyway,
so was right.
That band went on to win the competition,
yes, they did.
Which was proved that we sticking to our principles and looking for something original, something that you could see could be developed. That
so
was good.
Your first recording in here?
And the prize was to record here, and so
and
they were the first.
Before the glass recording. Right?
Before anything, they were the first band to come in and plug in guitars and play live like a band, and the singer, we surrounded the singer with...
Well, you had Adam Lambert do a little something here, right?
He came later, but that was more of a songwriting
thing.
Experimental thing. That was the full band, and they programmed the drums. And
What did he have to say about it?
I think he was shocked at how good it was,
yeah,
and how weird yet uplifting the desert is.
Right. Because, I mean, you come all the way out here, you go, this is out in the middle of nowhere, you go out in the middle of dirt roads to get here, and then it's just, wow.
If you live in the Hollywood Hills, this is quite a trip for you,
yes,
even though it's
yes,
only 100 miles.
Yes.
It's 100 miles and a few thousand years.
Now, separate. So today I'm here, because I'm producing a project,
okay,
and loving every minute of the studio, loving everything about it, the engineers, everyone.
Okay.
I'm producing Calista's new recordings. And I've got Bobby Carradine, which is her uncle, here playing guitar. I've got incomparable Alvin Taylor on drums, Solomon King on guitars, and one of his songs that we're recording is he wrote. And we got Jimmy over here on bass. And who am I missing?
Yeah.
This was
Deanna Bogart, who was supposed to be in the room. Deanna is currently
overdubbing
in the studio across the way from us.
And Don doesn't get with the violins, but this place, I mean, you know, I recruited these guys and trapped them here in the middle of nowhere in this most beautiful, peaceful surrounding. Where
and you did a wonderful job.
Chill. Well, I asked around, you know, they live in L.A. and we live in Palm Springs.
Right.
So we have people scattered about. This was kind of a middle ground.
Right.
But it's also away from everything. And once you get up here, you might as well pay attention to what you're doing.
I wanted to ask you guys, because I'm so enthralled with the studio. You know, naturally, I'm when I put this out, it's going to have all the video of the footage of the place and everything. I wanted to get each one of you to tell me what you think of it. Bobby, what do you think of the studio?
Well, I walked into the studio and I saw one of the holy grail amps of all time, like a Fender Vibraphone with a JBL in it. And I looked at Solomon and I said, that's it.
I said, Bobby, that's your amp.
Yeah, I know, man. It's just, right then I knew we were in a good place.
So we know what amp we're using for you, then I take it.
Oh, yeah. If I play electric, I'm playing through that.
Okay, all right.
What I think is that I'm moving in. I'm
Solomon is now officially moving into the studio.
I'm the guy from the Hollywood Hills that came here all stressed out and going, wow, anything is possible. I'm really, really happy.
Anything
to be
is
here.
Possible.
Thank you for creating.
Alvin?
Yeah, I think the only thing that's missing in the studio is a 24-hour session drummer, so I think I'll move.
He's moving in with Solomon, and I think, so Jimmy, what do you think of the studio?
How about an in-house rhythm section?
Yeah, right. Yeah, we're all going to move
I
in.
I think it's great. I don't do a lot of recording, but I've never seen a studio like this before in my life. As far as the amenities, as far as where the company, isolation, the beauty. It's an inspiring atmosphere.
And you got to admit that the pink is really kind of cool.
Well, it grows on you.
You can't miss it. You drive up, if you want to tell somebody how to get to Pink Satellite Recording, you just say, look up when you're going up the dirt road. You can't miss the pink.
You have the dirt road kind of high.
And the retro inside, I mean, I understand that Chris's wife came up with all this color stuff.
Chris's wife is very creative. Pink is her color,
right,
and this is her design, and I love what she's done because it's
very, very retro, eclectic. Yeah.
And she's not done yet. I mean, she's going to be more outside.
Did you have her do your place?
Mine's staying green. And we talked about trying to get some Joshua trees planted here.
Right, you tell me. Somebody that implants them.
Well, it's a very difficult thing because they don't like being moved.
Right.
But constructors and contractors are obliged to relocate them. You can't just chop them down.
Right.
So if you're doing any work,
right,
you have to take it up and take it somewhere.
Very carefully.
Very, very, very carefully.
Why?
The love and the expertise that's going into this place, I think you could have a world-class destination studio.
Here, you need a...
It never started out like that, but we're sort of heading down that road, and I think that if everything we do, we try to do to the utmost, then it will be the kind of place where people will look forward to coming to.
And then you're going to have Queen come in and do some recording and showing off. Maybe have a party?
Well, we've had Adam here, and Roger Taylor came by and had dinner, and we got drunk and played something. I can't remember what it was. Who knows?
We could do a little Queen private concert.
What it's all about is once we're fully functional and we've got all this stuff done, then I will be encouraging people I know to come.
Right. Until then, hold on. Hold on to your hats soon.
I would encourage anyone to come up here.
I gotta say, as a recording engineer myself with a degree, after all my management experience, my production experience, this studio is it's coming so close to being just amazing. I mean, the sound quality in there is not what you would expect.
Right.
I mean, it's really quite something. Everybody's so comfortable with it. Everybody's so happy with the whole ambiance and the whole way they're treated. And
that's half the battle, isn't it, really?
It's half the battle, yeah.
If you feel good, then you play good, and you don't worry about anything.
That's right.
Let's turn your phone off, and life is perfect.
That's right.
Well, what's the official name of the studio?
Pink Satellite Studios.
Okay. Pink Satellite.
And is that like a website, too?
It will be in about 4 or 5 days. At the moment, there's a brochure that you can download with photographs and equipment list.
Well, they had a professional photographer took pictures.
But Kyle over there, who's laying out your dinner.
Hi, Kyle.
She's also marketing and PR and website chief.
Very good.
And that's all just being finished as we speak. So
very good.
So by the end of next week, we think we'll have everything.
I got to tell you, I've recorded in a lot of studios, including George Harrison's Friday Park. I did 33 and a third album there.
Did you? I love that record.
Yeah, I've been drunk on that album.
Wow.
For George Harrison. And I also did Elton John, a couple albums with him at a place called Super Bear in France.
Yes.
Super Bear. And not to mention...
Honky Shatter.
Not to mention the Record Plant and Electric Ladyland and all the other great studios. I probably played in all of them.
Right.
And compared all those even major studios to this studio, you got a lot of stuff going on here. You have this studio has a major, major potential to be something just incredible.
Especially nice to
be here in the desert.
You're right.
Oh man, that's amazing. People would fly all over the world to come here.
It's where it is.
Yes.
It's like. Picture, in another circumstance of an example, picture a studio on the top of a mountain with nothing else on the mountain, but it's at the very top, and it has a view of everything. It's isolated, it is private, it's quiet, and it's just the beauty. If you love the desert and Joshua Tree, this is the place to come.
Sure.
This is it. So I think we're good. So Coachella Music Show on location. In Joshua Tree
at
Pink Satellite
Studios. Yay!